继续看，美国白宫与国务院6号表示，美国国务卿布林肯仍然计划在合适的时机与中方商讨访华时间，重新安排行程。美国认为回收中国无人飞艇残骸具有情报价值，美国政府无意将打捞的残骸归还中国。
继中国无人飞艇误入美国领空后，中国外交部副部长谢峰6号表示，美方执意对即将离开美国领空的民用飞艇滥用武力明显反应过度，严重违反国际法精神和国际惯例，美方所作所为严重冲击损害巴厘岛会晤以来双方稳定中美关系的努力和进程。美国国务院在6号承认美方失去了一次与中国面对面对话的重要机会，但否认责任在美方。
Your reaction to critics saying that the United States overreacted due to domestic political pressure, since this incident happened, a similar incident happened before, and given the fact Secretary Blinken is going to be the first secretary to visit China.4 years.
We had an opportunity. We had what would have been a valuable opportunity to engage in that face-to-face diplomacy. It was to have been a near-term diplomacy. Of course, the blame does not fall to us for undermining that opportunity.
One, just on what my colleague just used the term, overreacting with regard to China, is how much truth do you think it is in if you say that... The U.S. overreacted with this President Biden being pressured from like the U.S. media a little too much, and there is not much truth into the surveillance equipment terminology there.
It is a fundamental misunderstanding of the United States to suggest that we take these sort of actions based on anything other than what's in our national interest. When it comes to what we've heard from the PRC, I'm just not going to give that too much oxygen.
美国国务院表示，中美高层官员仍然在保持对话，肯访华行程进行磋商，但布林肯仍然计划访华。
President Biden is a big believer in personal diplomacy. Isn't it more important than ever to talk to China in person, or even to confront China? Is there any preconditions to resume the talk?
We too are.
有些人对这个凤凰的记者提了一些个评论啊，就是这位记者，这位朋友说，凤凰记者提问颇有发言人的神采，居高临下质疑美国人不懂事儿，不按规矩来，就他一个人戴着口罩，声音严厉，眼神空洞，却通过底气掩饰底气的不足。这位朋友说，我也喜欢看人的眼神，就是发现这个人的眼神无神却空洞，他的眼神很浑浊，好像被抽干了精气神一样，也难怪上了船就这样。就是假大空啊，假模假样啊，在那里啊。评论，他在美国买房子了，早就被揭发了。在美国这些信息都公开，知道的早知道，不知道就不知道。义正言辞的训美国。反美是工作，美国买房是生活，就在美国的已经买房了。啊，装逼！曾经有人在那里提问嘛，就是他们的人被川普就问，你是官有的，你还是私营的？他说，哎，我们是私营的。